Good afternoon, everybody. Good morning or good night to whoever is watching this on live and whoever is watching this on replay. Today, I'm very happy, fortunate to have my second LinkedIn live stream and also on Facebook. I'm simultaneously live streaming and I would like to thank personally my guest, Sheetal Ramchandani, and my friend, Glory Jane Velasco. It's such an honor to be here before you. And before we start, let me just play a quick video and a countdown. So while people are joining, we can just, you know, breathe in and relax. Hello, good afternoon again from my side and good evening to Glory because she is in Malaysia. My first question to you and to those who are watching us live and those who will watch us on the play, are you struggling with weight loss? Are you stressed because you easily gain weight after losing it? Wait, my weight has been a roller coaster ride. And do you want to discover how can you lose weight with zero hunger and zero exercise? Okay, I just want to make sure that Glory and Sheetal is there. Can you see me clearly, both Sheetal and Glory?
Yes, we do.
Thank you. Okay, let me continue. Do you want to discover how to lose weight with zero hunger and zero exercise? If you answered yes to any of these questions, then you are on the right free webinar here on LinkedIn because I have the right people who can teach you how. And let me just first, I would like to thank everybody who's watching us live and on replay. And as a way of thanking you, I would like to give you, see, our speakers are very generous. They're giving you a free healthy recipe from Glory. So drop your email address here or please register in the form that I'm giving later so you can get a copy of the free ebook. Similarly, Sheetal has a free book that she's giving, so watch out for that. Let me just give a few statistics. Do you know, I know this webinar is especially for mothers, but the good thing is that whatever we're going to share here today is not only about mothers. But number one that I just mentioned, do you know that more than 80%, actually according to this article, 87% of women have problems with their stomach after pregnancy? You know, after 11 years of my, you know, being pregnant, at some point I was thinking, how come my tummy fat, you know, and my pregnancy fat did not go away? And it's not only about the tummy fat after pregnancy that is the problem that women are having now, not only about women but family and the society as a whole. According to this article as well, there's about 300% increase in overweight and obesity between 1975 and 2016. I can talk a lot about what's happening, and especially because of the pandemic last year, they said most people have gained weight. But thankfully for me, I have lost weight. That is why on this webinar, I'm joined by Sheetal and Glory, who's going to share with us what can you really do so you can achieve your weight loss with zero exercise and zero hunger. But really, I think, you know, we have a lot of health problems now on weight gain, obesity, overweight. What is the core problem? The truth is that no education taught us about the right foods to eat. I mean, when I was growing up, I remember in academics, I only learned about go, grow, and glow foods. That's it. And when I even became a mother, I mean, I'm just feeding my kids the normal food that we Asians eat. So how about you, Sheetal? I mean, is there anything that you studied in the past that's related to what's the right food to eat?
Well, again, to start off with, thank you, first of all, for having me here and able to spread this awareness with so many of you today. Coming to your question, Wanda, and saying, what is the right food? Number one thing I would always tell everybody, your body talks to you all the time. We need to pay attention. Listen to what is helping me. The body gives small signs that I could not digest. It took too longer. I'm bloated. I'm gassy. And we know that these foods don't work for any for us. So again, every body is very bio-individual. You know, even something like lentils are so, so healthy, but may work for some and may not work for you, which is absolutely fine. But on a generalization, I always say that even while growing up, we all knew fruits and vegetables are our body's best friends. And having more of them has always helped a lot of people. Of course, it may vary a bit here and there, depending on some vegetables may not suit you. But generally, having a lot of greens and having vegetables really makes that nutrient shift in your body. And that I would say, again, it's very, very bio-individual. There must be some foods that don't work for some people, but that's absolutely okay. And eating them in abundance is absolutely crucial for the human body.
That's very good. See, you're already getting a lot of wisdom from Sheetal, right? I mean, no education really taught us what are the right foods to eat. But I agree with her. Your body talks. Like for me, I love eating chips. But after eating chips, I can feel my throat paining already. So yeah. I think not only about the lack of education, I mean, in school, in academics, about eating the right food, but also the right education of listening to your body. Gloria, I know we are educated, I mean, in the same country, but yes, on a different school. Were there anything school that taught you about food?
The only thing that I could remember is the one that you mentioned, the Go, Grow, Glow, and the food pyramid. But now we really know that it isn't working right now. It is even the cause of our pandemic, of having our lifestyle diseases of type 2 diabetes. Then we have the stroke, we have a heart attack, and all of those fatty liver diseases. It's actually the root cause of those is eating the wrong foods coming from that belief that we know of the food pyramid.
That's very interesting, right? So we will talk more about that. Watch out for this webinar. If you do have questions, send it in, drop in. Glory and Sheetal will help me answer, all the questions that you have, because today is all about sharing our personal journey with weight loss and achieving our weight goal. And of course, sharing the stories of Glory and Sheetal's clients, because they're really the expert on this area. But so I would like to welcome you again for those who just joined us now. This is a free webinar that you're getting today, how to achieve your weight goals with zero exercise and zero hunger. And I am joined by Sheetal Ramchandani and Glory Jane Velasco. And I would just like to invite everybody. This is a free webinar by Working Moms Academy. And just to quickly explain, what is Working Moms Academy, you might ask? It is a platform and community that supports mothers struggling with stress and burnout by providing education lacking in school so mothers can succeed personally and professionally. I always believe, you know, and I learned this from Sheetal, the best gift that I can give to my children is myself. That is why this is the second webinar we're having, and we're talking about health, because I know that is the best thing I've given my children last year. And every week thereof, we have this weekly free webinar, so watch out for it. It's going to be every Saturday, 6 p.m. Singapore and Philippine time. And what are the topics we're going to cover in the next few weeks? We're talking about parenting, career, finances, entrepreneurship, relationships, and health. So last week, I had a discussion about how can you manage your kids online and homeschooling. And if those of you who are watching want to have an access of the recording, send me a message on LinkedIn or in Facebook, and I would love to share that recording with you. Okay, let's begin. How can you achieve your weight goals with zero exercise and zero hunger? When I told this to my friend yesterday, she's like, really? you might be in doubt, but let me also tell you the story of what happened to me. And before that, I would like to thank everyone again for watching us live, and to thank you. Other than the book, the recipe book that Glory is giving us, there's going to be a free book also by Sheetal Ramchandani. So leave your email address or register later in the form link that I will give so you can get these free books from Sheetal and also from Glory. So can I just tell a quick story about myself? I'm a mom of two girls. I've struggled with weight loss for 11 years. Why 11 years? Well, my eldest daughter is 11 years, and I've seen how much my weight has grown. You know, when you're pregnant, right, you just feel the need to be pampered into it, anything you want. But after the pregnancy, it was really a struggle for me. Like my weight is a roller coaster, right? It's gonna be up, down, up, down. But last year, through the Wild Fit program, of which Glory is a certified coach, I was able to finally find something that worked for me, and I was not required to exercise, thankfully. Second, I did not go hungry at all, and I was able to lose 15 pounds in 90 days last year, because I enrolled in March, and I was in June, I was able to lose 15 pounds already. I was very happy about the results, so I was very passionate to really inform and educate a lot of people that it is possible for you to lose and to achieve your weight goal just by sharing whatever three steps and three struggles that, you know, that you are facing and how it could, you know, it could help you. And I am also the founder of Working Moms Academy. And, you know, after suffering from burnout in 2014, it has been my life mission to help others live happier lives. And with that, I would like to give the stage to Sheetal. Sheetal, if you can just tell people who are watching us live who you are and what do you do and what brought you here today.
Okay, fantastic, Wanda. I'm a health coach from the Institute of Integrative Nutrition, USA. And I specialize in two areas. One is hormone health and the other is emotional eating. Which means, you know, when women suffer with hormonal imbalances, one as yours, like I had my children and I could not lose weight because hormones, of course, go up and down during the pregnancy and during childbirth, but they never come back to normal space. And that is an hormonal imbalance. The others would be like PCOS, thyroid, reproductive disorders, just to name a few other hormone imbalances. And as an emotional eating coach, which means for those who use food, alcohol, or smoking as a coping mechanism to manage their stress or emotions. And that's the two areas that I specialize in. I'm founder of my company, Live Lively, where we do corporate webinars and wellness sessions for corporates as well and the wider community. Apart from all that, I'm a mom for two boys aged 20 and 14. And what brought me to doing the work that I do was my own journey. Having lost my father to cancer at a very early age, I learned the most important lesson in my life, that health is the most important thing to have. You may have everything in the world, and if you do not have health, you literally, you know, don't have anything. And giving birth to both my boys, I weighed too much. I went through this roller coaster, same ride like what you did, Wanda. And all I wanted in this journey was to be in my fittest, healthiest version so that I could be there for my kids. And that is why I say the greatest gift you can give your children is your own health. And that's all I wanted for the kids. And I just could not find that right balance. That brought me to becoming a health coach first myself, curing myself, and then becoming a certified legit health coach here in the UAE.
Thank you, Sheetal, for sharing that. You know, my father also died very early. I was only 9 when he died, and it was of a heart attack. And I know it's also related to health, right? The good thing about, I think death is something we cannot stop, but, you know, moving out from suffering. And as you know, as you said, the best gift we can give to our children is our health. So thank you again for joining me, and you will learn more about Sheetal later. But let me introduce also our speaker, my friend Glory Jane Velasco. Yes, Glory.
Hi, thank you very much, Wanda, for having me here. So yes, everyone, I'm Glory Jane Velasco. So I'm the first Filipino certified WildFit coach. What brought me here is because I went from a very uncertain person who suffered from inconsistent energy levels. I had cystic acne before, and then I had chronic sinusitis. I also had chronic fatigue. I had low quality sleep. I was having a weakening memory, and it was already very alarming to me. I was having brain fog and weight gain, and I was lost on what to eat and what to do because I've been going to the gym for straight 2 years, twice a day. That's 7 a.m. and 8 p.m. and I couldn't shed the excess weight that I was having. So from that uncertain person, I was transformed into this person who is now certain and who is now very confident, who has reversed all those undesirable conditions. And the most important thing is I was able to help my mother reverse type 2 diabetes. And because of that, I was able to realize that, hey, like my mother had been to the doctor for how many years, but it really didn't help her a lot. But just by sharing with her what I have learned from this WildFit program, she was able to turn her health around in just a matter of 90 days. So I was really like so overwhelmed with it. And then I realized that I was already living my childhood dream of becoming a superhero. It's like, wow, I saved someone else's life. And it's not just someone else, but it's my mother. And so it really helped me a lot to realize as well how important nutritional science is. And we are not having this kind of education in our society right now. So that's the reason why it really drove me to become a certified WildFit coach. I've been doing a lot of webinars already, free webinars as well, because I also want to spread this awareness with other people. And because of that, I also see that my vision that I really want is to live in this healthy community full of physically strong, clear-minded, and emotionally stable individuals. And I believe that in order to achieve this, we always start at home. So that's the reason why the moms hold a very vital key here in establishing healthy habits for their kids. So mothers have the best opportunity to shape a new generation of healthy individuals, because kids learn what they live, and then they live what they learn. And 80% of what they learn is coming from childhood, coming from home. Yeah, so that's the reason why my mission is to empower moms to regain good health, transform their body weight and shape, and their relationship around food. And also using this simple, proven three-step process to reset, rebuild, and revitalize the body within 90 days or less, using natural food sources, zero supplements, and zero requirements for exercise, so that they can have that energy that match their children and also their work. And most importantly, for them to become the best role model for their children in order to develop those healthy lifestyle.
Thank you very much, Glory, for that. You can sense, right? I can sense the passion and the positive energy of both Glory and Chital on this advocacy of health. That is why they are the right people who can help you. Both Glory and Chital have their own programs already, and you can get in touch with them right away. But in the future, Working Moms Academy is going to have a tie-up with them so they can really help you. But you know, just to say a bit about Glory, I met her in 2017 in Millionaire Mind Training in Malaysia. And from then on, we've worked a lot, you know, and she was really the one who inspired me in my health journey. After seeing what happened to Glory and after so much education from her, I followed her path of taking the program. That's why I brought her here today, and you can sense the passion in both person. I'm sure you're going to learn a lot. Feel free to ask questions. We're going to go back and answer that after this the session, after we have the discussion. But let me start now. What are the three reasons why weight loss is a struggle? Number one, I think the number one reason why weight loss is a struggle, not only to mothers, but to every person there is. Number one, your beliefs are sabotaging you. As Napoleon Hill said, what the mind can conceive, you can achieve. Let me just share my experience. What happened to me when I started to, you know, being really committed of weight? Last year, I said, I'm going to be 40 last year. I want to make sure I'm going to shed off all the weight that I've wanted for years. And the first thing I did is, of course, I ate less. It failed me. Second, I enrolled in the gym. And after 3 to 6 months of being in the gym, you know, my youngest daughter told me and said, Mommy, I'm very sorry, but I don't see any change in your weight. So I was...
You're a very honest daughter.
Yeah. So I have a very honest daughter, which I was thankful for, because I realized there's not really something that's working. So that is when I said, wait, I think I need to stop and go back to find what is working around me. And I remember, meeting Glory in 2017 and seeing her weight journey 2018, I was like, I think what Glory did was something that is really good. So that is when I said, okay, let me just do then the WildFit program. So last year, as a birthday gift to myself, I've invested, actually the program is quite expensive, it's $900, but actually it's cheaper than my gym enrollment for the year. So, but after taking the program, I mean, I really had zero exercise, zero hunger for 90 days. And I myself was surprised of the results. And what I learned is that really it's my mind that sabotaged me. Number one, I thought eating less will make me, you know, lose and achieve, lose the weight and achieve my weight goal. But what I also learned is that it's the same 80-20 principle. 80% of weight is because of nutrition and only 20% is exercise. So this is my journey. And I would love to hear, Sheetal, I mean, before you become a health coach, what was your, how are your beliefs affecting you? And also if you could share, how about your clients? How were you able to help them have the mind shift to have the weight goal that they wanted?
Fantastic, Vonda. Actually, mindset plays such a huge role right from the day, you know, when you join in. And you, I would have clients come to me, the first thing would be, I want to lose weight. And my connection always goes back, what are your health concerns? And they say, I want to lose weight, you know. And even to start at that point, you know, to first I get them very, very close to their why. Why do you want to lose weight? Get, let's write it down for you. And why I do that is because I get them connected to their why. Secondly, what, you know, we help clients do is this mindset shift, create this awareness. You know, what are these negative opinions you hold about yourself? It could be going from I'm terrible at marketing to no matter what I do, I will never lose weight. And that's when I start my step backwards. How did you form these opinions? What people, circumstances contributed in making you believe this? Now let's put down on paper, what are the facts that no matter what you did, you've never lost weight? And when we just create this awareness that there is no fact, what are the facts? Putting down in point and bullet point form, there are no facts. It's just an opinion that they have lived there so many years with, that no matter what I do, I will never lose weight. Or whenever I do, I fall off the wagon. And these are the kind of, you know, mindsets that people have. So that's where we start. This is an opinion, and let's put a fact. Let's get closer to your why. And then we move backwards in first just setting the stage for them, helping them make their journey much easier. Because, of course, we all know that these beliefs actually sabotage you and do not let you move. You know, the journey is actually easy if you, your mind is on one side. But that's what we start doing. And that's what I did to myself as well. So when I suffered a hormonal imbalance, my why used to be, I want to be the healthiest version for my children. And why am I holding this opinion? I could not put it down in paper that when I did it the right way, I was achieving results. So of course, then I would say it is your beliefs that sabotage you initially, and mindset. And that's why health coaching is a concept which largely believes that it's not only the food that you eat, it's not only the exercise, it's not only the amount of good quality sleep you have, but how does these, you know, primary lifestyle things, your relationships, your work, your career, your finance affect you and create this mindset for you. So yeah, that would be on my side. What about you, Glory?
Oh, thank you. So for my side, so what happened was, because my background is in electronics engineering, so I'm I'm an electronics communications engineer by background, then I have this really strong passion to health. And what happened is, when this is the gap that I saw and I observed, because whenever I want to buy a gadget, so I often look for specifications, so specs. So it's like, oh, I want to buy this phone, then I want to know what size I would like, and then what is the camera specs and all of those. But never did we ask ourselves question like, what is the specs for the human diet? It's like we always ask ourselves what the specs for the TV, this gadget, and this mobile phone, but how about for the human diet? Did we ever ask that? And then I realized by joining this WellFit program that we have a very strong disconnect in terms of what we are eating right now versus to what we really evolved to eat. So the history of our human diet has really, really come to a different point in such a way that what we are eating right now is totally filled with so much processed foods with a very high salt, so super processed carbohydrates, and also with a lot of fats and then also salts in it that are not anymore natural for the body to digest. Whereas our body has evolved to eat those natural foods, so which are vegetables and then the fruits. And we also have the lean meats and then the healthy kinds of fats, which is the omega-6 fatty acids and also the MCTs from the avocado. So we have really veered so much away from our natural diet that we have seen this evolutionary mismatch between what we evolved to eat versus what we are eating right now. And this is what causing us pain as well as weight gain. Because when we are having pain, that means the body is having illness or sickness, the body would prioritize first healing and then weight loss. So weight loss is just a byproduct when your body is already starting to heal. So that was already a big mind shift for me. And this is what I'm also teaching to my clients, and which my clients have also learned all throughout the 90-day program, because the first step is always changing the mindset, resetting the mindset from being an unconscious eater towards being a conscious eater on what really are the foods that constitute the real human diet.
Wow. See, I hope, you know, whoever is watching us today is learning a lot already. See, I myself know about this, but I'm learning a lot from Sheetal and from Gloria. As Sheetal said, you know, if the why is, you know, if the why is clear, the how is easy. And I think it's about the clarity of that. And as Glory said, that the mind shift is very important for you to achieve whatever you want. It's about mindful eating. I mean, as we live our busy life, like, just eat, eat, and eat. And then later, we're like, I'm still eating, but I'm still hungry. And it's because also of the lack of mindfulness and the focus of how we eat. So let me just move to the next one. It is a very interesting, right, in terms of the discussion. Number two, this is what also I think. Your habits are not helping you. One of the reasons why women, moms, and a lot of people are, you know, struggling with their weight goals is because of our habits. Like being Asian myself, we know that we have to eat 3 times a day, breakfast, lunch, dinner. I remember my mom will always say, you know, you will go hungry and you will not have energy in school if you don't eat breakfast, rice in the morning. And that is the same knowledge I passed on to my kids. So it's the habit of, you know, them. And now I cannot break. It's kind of difficult also for me now to break the habit of them not having breakfast as rice, because they also like, but mommy, I need rice for breakfast, I have PE today. So really the habits, and I mean, here in Dubai at least we eat 3 times a day, but back in the Philippines we also have a siesta or merienda, Sheetal, as we call it. So we eat like 3 to 6 times a day. So there's breakfast, snack, lunch, snack, dinner, and midnight snack. So
we eat a lot.
So we have the culture of eating. So I learned that, you know, after that, taking the 90-day program, I was actually allowed to eat the whole time. But it's about choosing the right foods. And when my kids also learn and started to see what I'm doing, they're copying me as well. So they started to eat the green juice that I'm taking. If I'm not taking chips and I'm just, you know, baking those potatoes, they're like, oh, mommy, this is the healthiest. We love it. So it's really the habits that we have that sabotage that can break us or give us a breakthrough. And for me, it's the habits that I started that I am starting to now help my children have it also. So how about you, Sheetal? What is your experience about these habits for yourself and for your clients?
So, you know, Wanda and Glory, growing up in India is no different from growing up in Philippines. We eat a lot as well, you know, and everything revolves around food. You know, when you're happy, we have food. We are sad, we have food, you know, and that's how we grew up. So when I was growing up, my mom had these 3 questions for me all the time. All Indian moms have that, you know. Did you eat? Did you sleep? Did you poop? And these are the 3 questions that she used to ask me. So the moment I would say, I'm not feeling too well today. I'm not, you know, I have a tummy pain. Or these are the 3 questions she used to ask me. Did you eat? Did you sleep? Did you poop? And obviously one of them would be not in place, right? Mm-hmm. And then she said, see, I told you, you need to have these 3. And as I became a mother, and at that time I was not a health coach, I did the same. So the same habit continued. I used to ask my kids the same question and said, oh, this is gross question. Don't ask us this question. And of course, yeah, so this is how they were. But then, of course, as you know, I was educated, and what Glory said, I really loved. You know, she says, our kids are what we live. So what I lived was those 3 questions. But as I changed, you know, into a health coach, and I learned so much about nutrition, we learned so much about right foods. We now can identify what is processed, what is clean, what is nice. And what I was doing, my kids were watching me day by day. And that's what they lived. And I really, really love this sentence that you said, Glory. I really can relate how we pass on this habit just by living it ourselves. And they watched me, why green juice? You know, why is mom having fruits and vegetables every day? And I used to say, I tell them, if you can't eat them, drink them. And that's the habit they left, have developed. So now my son moving back to university, he lives on his own in the US. And he has the same habits because he lived these habits with the parents. And that is why it is so important as moms, all the moms watching us, you just need to do it. And your children are watching you with the habits that you have, and they will take it with you.
Thank you, Shita, for sharing that. I mean, I've learned that my kids will not say will not do what I say, but they will always do what I do. So this is why, and this is why also Working Moms Academy is focusing on mothers, because I know that when we do educate the mothers, it will have a chain effect on the children, on the husband, on the friends, and on the entire family. This is what it is all about, because you need to learn what habits you got from your mom or your parents that is not helping you disrupt that, change that, so you can create something new for your family. So thank you, Shita, for sharing it. But before, I was thinking, when I'm in Dubai for 13 years now, and I used to think, if Indians are vegetarians, why are they also big? Because the concept of my mindset is, if you're eating vegetable, you should be thin, right? But as you said, right, I think it's also the things that we put in the food that really gives you the weight. Because a lot of my Indian friends are explaining, you don't know how we cook vegetable, Wanda, and how much we put in that. So that's why we have weight also. So that's very interesting. So how about Glory? Can you just share with us about this topic of habits?
Ah, of course, right? Because we both grew in the Philippines, so we know that what we have learned from the Philippines is a meal is incomplete without rice. So that's number one. It's like, you really cannot call something a meal, a complete meal, if it doesn't have a rice. So rice has become a staple food in the country. So I've been looking out for rice every time. So I'm away from my family. So I'm always looking out for rice, especially when I'm doing some work. So I have these rules or meaning in my mind that if I'm doing some work, I need to eat a lot. So these are the things that I have learned from my childhood, because I was, again, looking at my parents and how they do things, like, oh, is that how adults do it? And they have been in this world for quite some time. So maybe those things work. But then I have learned, which is the thing that I want to share with you also right now, is from James Clear. So he's the author of the book Atomic Habits. So he has a very nice pattern on how we create habits and how we can also use this in order to create a healthy lifestyle. So for example, this is what he calls the habit loop. So it starts with CCRR. So that means cue. And then the cue triggers the craving. So you're craving for something. So the cue is making you aware that there is an imminent reward in your surrounding. And then the cue triggers your craving. So you crave for like a chocolate chip cookies, or you crave for an ice cream, or you crave for a cake. So say you are having acute stress, you're feeling stress, and that moves you to think about and crave for chocolate chip cookies. And by the way, this is one example from a client. And the craving would motivate you to create a response. So this is the action that you would take in order to respond to the craving. And so what she had to do is to look for the cookie jar and then get some cookies out there and then eat it. So that's the response. So the reward is the state, emotional state change that she was after because of the cue. So the reward strengthens the craving, and also it strengthens the cue. And now the cue is associated with the reward. So every time she feels stressful, immediately what triggers in her mind is chocolate chip cookies. But the thing is, we are lost in this kind of loop because we only know cue and reward, cue and reward. We didn't know about the craving and then the response. So if we know about this, then we can interrupt the pattern. So how to interrupt this is very, very simple. So if you have a habit that is not working with you, so for example, with a chocolate chip cookies, what we need to do is, for the cue, make it invisible. So that means place the cookie jar in a in a very inconspicuous place. You cannot really find it. You put it into a cupboard on the highest part so that you cannot really see it, make it invisible. And then number two, in terms of the craving, is make it unattractive. So that means if you get to find a cookie jar, place a note on it. This is diabetes in a jar. So that would make the jar unattractive.
Discourage.
Yeah, discourage yourself. And number three is in terms of the response, make it hard. So by putting the jar in a very far away place, you are making it hard. In business, we call it barrier to entry. So it's making it difficult for you to get the cookie jar. Lock it. So lock the cupboards. It's very difficult to get it. And number four is in terms of the reward, make it unsatisfying. So that means like, oh, you feel the bloatedness. So magnify how you feel 30 minutes later when you feel the energy drop, and then connect that drop in energy to the food that you're eating and make it unsatisfying. So the same thing is true if you want to build a healthy habit. So in terms of the cue, make it visible. So if you want to eat vegetables and fruits, make it visible. Put it in on your table. Put it everywhere. Print pictures of your goals. Post it in your kitchen, in every part of your house, and then make yourself connect to your whys. Why are you eating these healthy foods? And then number two is make it attractive. So this is in terms of the craving. So make the craving attractive. So that's the reason why we print all those reasons why you want to become healthy, to make these vegetables and fruits attractive for you. And then also print the pictures of the slim body that you wanted to have. And in terms of like the response, make it easy. So then make it available, make it accessible for everyone to just grab it, eat it. So in terms of fruits, that means you do some food preps. You cut all of these fruits beforehand and put into the fridge. So every time you become hungry, you just grab it and on your fridge. So you can just enjoy it anytime. And also in terms of the reward, make it satisfying. So really connect how you feel with the food that you're eating that was giving you that burst of energy and also that clarity of mind. So that is what I wanted to share about habits.
Wow, that's a lot of things in there. I hope you're learning a lot from both Sheetal and Glory. But it's really true, right? I mean, you have to make things difficult or easy for you, because the mind, I mean, after studying NLP, I learned that the mind works on two ways. It's based on benefits or based on pain. So if you want to stop eating, make it painful for you to achieve or to get that cravings that you wanted, and also reward your things with better things, right? So that's very good. Actually, that leads us to the next number three. I think one of the reasons why weight loss is a struggle, not only for mothers, but for everybody, is because of our feelings. I like this quote, when I am in trouble, eating is the only thing that consoles me. So actually it's right. What you eat is based on your emotions, and it's always connected to our mindset also. Like for example, for me, I learned that when I am upset or when I am stressed, I immediately will grab an ice cream. And if I will reflect back on my childhood, especially during college days, when, you know, after my examinations in accountancy, it was always very difficult. And my mom and I will always have this conversation of how tough the exam was. And she will, to comfort me, she'll always say, okay, tell me about it, and we'll walk and buy ice cream. So ice cream has become my comfort food. So, you know, I think every person is like that. If you're also happy, right, you also think of what is, if I want to be happy, I immediately grab a coffee. Because for me, coffee is achievement. I mean, when I was growing up, I didn't have money to even buy a Starbucks. I was able to buy a Starbucks when I was working. And also every month only, because of the budget requirements. I mean, I have only minimal budget for coffee. So, you know, when I want to be happy, Starbucks is a reward I give myself, because it's, you know, it's a reminder for me that I have achieved something. And this is something that I can buy now anytime I want and at, you know, at any frequency. But it was harming my health at some point. I remember taking two coffee at a day, and then I will be palpitating and having problems sleeping. So really, your feelings is something that's related to your food, and it's also not good if you are not aware of it. So maybe Sheetal, you can walk us through about your experience, and again, how your clients, I know, how is emotional eating? I know you're an expert on this also. Maybe you can tell more us about that.
Yeah, so fantastic. You know, Wanda has already covered, you know, what emotional eating is always. We have this trigger that you mentioned, and we reach out to a cookie jar or maybe alcohol for some people. And what we forget is why our behavior, what's causing us, you know. So this is exactly what we do with clients is, you know, let them identify that this is a trigger. So I have this one client, just like, you know, you said that whenever your exam went tough, the reward for you was an ice cream. So she had a different way to manage her anger. So every time she had a conversation with her brother, it used to be such a stressful conversation. Then she used to reach out and have cookies, and she would literally finish the whole jar, then which used to suffocate her. And she could not connect this dot first. So we, you know, help her identify what happens, what's the trigger. And every time she used to bring up these conversations with her brother. And then the emotional eating part was reaching out to something sugary, sweet, cake, cookies, chocolates. And she did not know why she was doing that. But of course, it was the anger that she was managing. So the emotion was anger. And that's what we helped her identify first. What is causing you? Which emotion are you feeding here? And that's a question that, you know, even if you are doing something like that, ask yourself, which emotion am I feeding here? Okay. And then we share a few mindful strategies and tips. So with her, I used to tell her, okay, before you reach out to any cookie, again, just like you, you know, create a little higher store, bring it down. And she would do everything to bring that cookie jar from the highest level to her level. And then the trigger that, you know, to keep some breaks, like you have to still give her a break. I said, for every cookie you eat, have one glass of water. So imagine having five glasses of water and five cookies. You're overfull. And she felt horrible. Yeah, she felt horrible. So I said, you still reach out. And that was her distraction. So, you know, when we say, I am feeding my anger with the cookie, what was I doing to distract her? So for every cookie, reach out to the cookie. You've done everything to bring it down back. We put it up in a cupboard, locked it up, but you bought it back. So let's have a glass of water with every cookie. So finish a cookie, glass of water. You can reach out to another cookie, another glass of water. So that was creating distraction for her, which then led her to take one step back. So identify something, you know, you could do. For another client, we shared a tip of eating with the left hand instead of the right. Yeah, and that is again, disrupting the flow. So, okay, you can reach out, but you have to use the left hand to eat. And that's all I need from you. So, you know, you say my right hand is gone for a holiday. If you feel that you still reach out, put it behind your back and keep it this way, you know, in a yoga pose so that you have only your left hand. And that was the distraction we used for him, so that, you know, when he's using out and he was then again having a similar situation, a finance crisis, he would reach out and, you know, to reach out to sugary food. So use your left hand. And then it was so difficult. How long can you eat with your left hand? It's not easy. It's not comfortable. It's messy. You drop stuff, especially when you're stressed. Yeah. So these are few tips, you know, if any of you are seeing that this is my trigger, and this is what I do. Number one is ask yourself, what emotion am I feeding? And what break can I apply? Can I apply any of these two tips, either water or using my left hand, and see whether it works for you?
That's very interesting. I'm learning a lot, Shita. Thank you for sharing that. See, eating, I mean, if you're a right-handed person, makes sense to eat on the left. So you'll find it difficult. Now, if you're left-handed, should use the right hand. So the concept is not to eat only by the left, but make it difficult.
So you make it
the non-dominant hand, right? So that's very interesting. And you are correct, right? I mean, eat a cookie, but take a glass of water in between. I think I'll do this for my daughter.
I mean, it's hard.
What you started doing, because also one of the habits is after a meal, dessert, right? So instead of grabbing dessert, I told her, okay, baby, instead of grabbing dessert after a meal, grab an apple. So somehow that's changing already as a pattern. But I think, yeah, when I see her being stressed about school also, okay, get a cookie and then drink one glass of water. Then she cannot finish a whole pack in one sitting. That's a very good one. Thank you for sharing. Okay, how about you, Glory? Maybe you can tell us some stories also.
Yes, certainly. Because also in WorldFit, what we call it is emotional hunger. So this is one of the most common and dangerous forms of dysfunctional eating. So there are six hungers, but we are just focusing now on emotional hunger because people eat emotions and our stomach is the seat of all emotions. So food is used to satisfy these emotions. So that's the reason why that also the way that we are living today is having a lot of emotional emptiness and emotional void, which we often fill with foods. So I have a lot of clients who are angry eater, stress eater. A lot of them are stress eater, addicted eater into different foods, and then also bingers and sabotage. So these are the different types of emotional hunger eaters. So the best one that I can also share is I have this client who is a full-time trader, stock trader. So you know when the stock price rises, it's like, way, yay, I'm so happy. The stock is going high. And then when the stock price goes down, because like, oh my God. So that gives a lot of cortisol to the body, which is the stress hormone. And you know, when you have cortisol running into your body, you couldn't function well in terms of like making good decisions. So she would immediately reach out for her comfort food. Because again, cortisol, a stress hormone, would communicate to your body that, hey, there is something that is uncertain here and something that is not comfortable and something that is dangerous. So what it wants, the body wants to feel safe. And so therefore, the mind would immediately reach out for comfort food, to reach out for comfort because she's feeling stressed and she's feeling frustrated. So it only makes sense for the mind to reach out for this comfort food, but that food is never, ever functional for the body. So what we did is, as what also our friend here has, Chital has also shared earlier, so we identify the trigger emotion and the target emotion. So like, what is the event that triggers you to reach out for this food? And what is the target emotion that you want to feel? So the trigger emotion is stress because of the stock price change and she lost some of her money. So she had to do some cut losses. And the target emotion is to feel good, just to feel good. So, and the shortcut to that is the comfort food. So what we did is we looked deeply into, okay, so how many boxes of pizza can you eat in order to fill in that void? Can that two boxes of pizza help you to become a good trader next time? Can that two boxes of pizza help you to become good decision maker on which stock to pick or not? When to cut the losses or when to get the gain? And of course, you eat five boxes of pizza, it wouldn't help you. It would even give you brain fog. So we just need to identify what's the trigger emotion, what's the target emotion, and what are the other things that can help you to interrupt this pattern so you wouldn't reach out for the dysfunctional food. And one of those things is meditation, because she was feeling stressed. So meditation is key, doing deep breathing exercises or doing stretching and yoga. So being in touch with yourself or with the environment, so with nature, that really helped her a lot.
That's very interesting. Thank you for sharing that, Glory. I remember when I was in Malaysia, there was one lady, she was offering a trading course, and also with the trading, an upgrade to that course is training with neuro-linguistic programming, because she is linking how traders are negatively, you know, eating and stress eating. So, and the way they trade is based on their emotions also. So it's not only about how they eat, right? So, you know, I hope you're learning a lot. I am learning a lot. Thank you, Glory and Chital, for sharing. And now, let us talk about what's the one step to lose weight. And this is, I mean, Glory and Chital have shared already, but what I really think, and from my personal experience, it's really about knowing yourself. As Aristotle said, that knowing yourself is the beginning of all wisdom. Chital have shared about knowing your why already. which is very important as a foundation for you to achieve your weight goal. Glory have spoke about knowing your triggers, because that can help you stop the craving and do something about it. And let me just give a few examples of how knowing yourself is important in achieving your weight goal. See, as you know, it's important to know your thoughts, your feelings, your emotions about food. They said, it's not the food that makes you fat. It's the thought about the food that makes you fat. Even before you grab that chocolate, right? It's your judgment about the chocolate that really can make you fat. What is also your metabolism? You know, my husband always has a very good weight all throughout. And I was always asking him, why are you not gaining weight? He said, I only have a simple thought. Even if, you know, I eat a lot, I say I have a very high metabolism. And I was like, wow. When I eat, I have judgment about food. But for you, it's a different thought of eating. So it's really about knowing yourself, right, and doing something about it. And what are your feelings about losing weight? Because losing is a negative word already. And in NLP terms, they said, don't say weight loss. Because anything that you lose, you will find it. That's why it's easy for people to lose the weight and gain it, because you said weight loss. You should say weight goal instead. And it's about knowing your fears, your motivation, your why. Your sleep chronotype, I realized, you know, I was reading this book, The Power of When. That's the book. Power of Now is the book, yeah. So it was telling about what time do you need to eat the book. You eat the food at some point in time, so you will have the proper digestion. You know, even the menstrual cycle, especially for women, is very important. What's the right food to eat? And again, knowing about the weight goals and blocks. So, Sheetal, can you share about how knowing your clients? I mean, every client is different, right? So how do you approach it to make sure that they get the right help from you?
So number one, you know, what something you said about the way we talk about food is really important. You know, labeling food as good, bad, and creating these labels that we have, you know, whether this is a bad food, this is not a good food, this is this, and the way we talk about, you know, my weight is this, and I need to get into a target weight. So again, a target for everybody is different. You know, for somebody who starts at 115 or somebody who starts at 60, that 115 may want to get to 60. But for 60, it may be a different target weight. So again, it is a different weight goal for each one. So number one, I again come back to, what does health mean for you? Does it mean only that number on scale? Are you feeling good? Are you pill-free? Do you have any diseases? That's how I say start identifying towards your health. How do you want your last 10 years to be? You know, those are the questions that I ask them, rather than, you know, what's your weight or how much weight do you want to lose? Because that approach does not help at all. Even if anybody listening right now, just ask these three questions. How do I feel? Do I have any diseases? Am I on any pills? And how do I want my last 10 years to be? And if you keep that thing in your mind, you will know yourself better. Your relationship with food will improve, and your relationship with yourself will improve. And that is what is the first question I do. And that is how we get connected then to our why.
Those are very powerful questions, Sheetal. Thank you for sharing that, right? I think it reframes you to where you are now.
Yeah,
and where you want to be, because it's also about taking 10 years from now. So that's very good. I know, Sheetal, you also have this family coaching, and also, you know, so later Sheetal will give you more information about that, but I hope you're learning a lot already. How about you, Glory? What are your thoughts about knowing oneself?
Yeah, this is very, very important. And awareness is really key to lasting change. So awareness. So that's the reason why that I overly stress that to my clients, that in everything that we do, please be aware. So always take note, observe how you are feeling. So when you are eating this food, observe first how it feels like when you decided to eat this food. And then while you are eating it, and then after you eat it, 30 minutes, 1 hour later. So always observe what is the impact of the food to you psychologically and also physiologically speaking. And then tie it to your goals. So is your goal feeling good? Did that food give you that kind of feeling? So if that food, for example, pizza, made your energy level dropped down significantly after you ate it. So that really is a mismatch towards your health goals. So that food is not really a good indicator that you are on your way, you're on track towards your goal. So that is the way of linking it. So awareness is key. Observe. So always observe how you feel and how it feels like to your mind, how it feels like to your, how it feels like to the body after you eat it. And then also the same way with the functional foods. So when you eat the good foods, how do you feel as well later or afterwards? How does the body feel like? So like, for example, at first, my clients are really like not feeling comfortable with the new changes that we're introducing with the food guidelines week by week. Because again, that is very natural because the brain, our mind really hates things that are not familiar, that the mind is not familiar with, and loves what is familiar. So with every new guidelines that we are introducing week by week, they are feeling this kind of like restriction. So the best thing that we can do, so like what you said also, Wanda, is to reframe that these foods, after you eat it for a while, take a look and observe how it feels like to the body. And then they were able to observe, like, yeah, my back pains, my severe neck pains and back pains are now gone. And also now I am saving like a lot of money every month because I don't go anymore to massage centers because I'm not feeling that pain anymore. My chronic headache is now gone. And so we relate as well what they are eating and what they are thinking and feeling to the foods that they are eating. So awareness is really key to lasting change. If you cannot make that connection, it's impossible for you to have lasting change because we have these circumstances that will like pop up. It's like stressful situation at work or whatnot. So whatever situation that comes to your life. And you will willpower, the use of willpower is just very, very short term. So, and also discipline. So that's the reason why that if you want to have like this change in relationship with food, you need to be aware of how food makes you feel and then commit to yourself on being healthy and also identify what foods will bring you to be on your path to your goal of being healthy.
That's very true. So thank you, Glory, for sharing that. I think that the first step to any change is always awareness. And what will keep you going is the commitment to continue no matter what is happening. So those are very important. I hope you're learning a lot already. Okay, so I just want to share. I know a lot of people are craving in terms of, you know, you think of what do I associate ice cream with or what do you associate McDonald's with? Is it your friends? Is it your family? For my kids, they associate McDonald's with family time because when they were younger, you know, right after office, you know, my way of bringing my kids over the weekends will walk together to the mall, then they will have their McDonald's. But this is something that I have to disrupt now. But something we are aware. So, you know, parents, mothers, how are you, you know, creating those habits for your children? Because it's the awareness also when they grow up, you know, you think of, as Chital said, you ask this question, how do you want yourself? So ask yourself, how do you want to see your kids 10 years from now? So I'm still a work in progress, but the good thing is I'm aware of it already. Alcohol, again, is another thing. So alcohol is always associated to family gatherings, right? So maybe if you're just feeling upset, you just call a friend or you call somebody, you reach out to Gloria or to Chital, can you help me with this already? If you already want to start with there, they have specific programs that I know and I fully believe that can help you. So feel free to reach out to Gloria and Chital here on LinkedIn or Facebook, and they will give and share more about their program and their contact numbers later. And I just want to invite those. Thank you again, Gloria and Chital, for joining me today. Next week, another interesting topic: how to talk so your husband and kids will listen. So we're gonna have it same time Saturday, 6 p.m. Singapore and time. My friend Jomark Bahiran, who's watching us live, Jomark, thank you for joining. Is having this webinar today. in 5 minutes. See, it's called Personal and Organizational Agility. Hope you will join him. Jomark has been very helpful on helping me understand how to navigate StreamYard and live streaming on LinkedIn and Facebook simultaneously. And Shital, please do invite those people. I know you could be of help to a lot of mothers and families who are on their weight goal journey. Can you just tell us more about your programs and how people can get in touch with you?
Okay, thank you so much, Wanda, for having me here today. It was a total pleasure. This is absolutely what I love doing, spreading more and more awareness. Absolutely passionate about my work. And yes, the screen shows you all my handles, which are my Instagram, my website, my email, my direct contact number. This is how you can reach out to me. I do have a 30-minute initial free session with anybody who just needs my services just to understand what are you looking for? What are your health concerns and the way forward for you? So definitely, if you want to get in touch with me, have the 30 minute with me. Let's understand where we are and where do we want to go from there. And that's all the platform right in front of you to reach out to me for your 30 minutes free. And I will share all my details with you with the different programs that we offer at Live Lively. Thank you so much, Wanda.
Thank you, Shital. I know, I mean, I've read her brochure. I know she do has family coaching, one-on-one coaching, and group coaching. Yeah. So please feel free to reach out with Shital so she can help you start your weight goals. Now, let me now, also later, we're going to announce we'll have one lucky winner with a free health coaching session with Shital. And before that, I would like to give Glory the opportunity to invite you. I know she's doing a Wild Fit starting. Is it starting next week, Glory? Maybe you can tell us more about that. Wow. So tell us more about your program and how people can join you.
Thank you, Wanda. So WildFit is a revolutionary program that really teaches you to transform the way you eat and your relationship around food. So you will have a long-term relationship with the functional foods and less of the dysfunctional foods. So this WildFit program runs for, again, 90 days. And I will start my next class this coming Monday, so February 15. And the next class would be on 3rd of May. You can always contact me via my Facebook page. I offer a lot of free webinars there. You can just find in the event section all of the available webinars that I put in. And also, you can email me directly to healthyandhappypinay@gmail.com. Also, to my website, you can visit it at healthyandhappypinay.com. So my email is at gmail.com. Yep. And then also, aside from being a WildFit coach, I'm also a rapid transformational therapist led by Marisa Peer. I'm also a certified life coach, certified trainer, certified 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, law of attraction coach as well. So I can really help you a lot, especially like in this life transformation work.
Thank you for that, Glory. You know, I brought Glory and Shital Hill because I always believe that, you know, passionate people are the best ones who can help you. So please get in touch with Shital and with Glory because I know they are the right persons who can help you achieve your weight goal this 2021. And of course, I would like to also invite those mothers, join the free support group on LinkedIn. So you get access to the free recording of this webinar, get access to free books. It's bit.ly. All capital letter WMA support group. Join the group and you will be connected with other amazing mothers because really Working Moms Academy is about moms learning from other moms and moms supporting each other so we can become better person, parents, and partners. And of course, we also have the online school which is now available. Go to bit.ly, again, all capital letters, WMA school. You can find all the programs that we have from career reinvention to moving from burnout to bliss, how to reinvent your career and find the land of your dreams. And in the future, we're creating more free courses and just watch out, go to the school, and you will get more updates about it. So with that, I would like to thank you. Let me see if we do have some questions. Let me stop sharing and see if we do have questions from some people. This is now the right time for people to ask. If you do have some questions, feel free to share. And, you know, ask us any questions to Shital and to Glory. Now it's still free to ask questions. So let's see if there are some questions. Okay. Oh, see, I think there are some comments from Annette. She said, the slogan of these big companies are confusing people. Example, McDonald's slogan is, I'm loving it. Yeah, I think, you know, that is how actually I think these big companies are playing in terms of our emotion, right? You associate McDonald's with love. So that's why when we want to feel love, we go to McDonald's. So these things like that, we just have to be careful about how we are being manipulated by, you know, but by these things. Thank you, Annette. Annette Caraballo Pacheco for joining us. She's from Puerto Rico. And I think we're going to give her that free coaching with Chital because she's the one who gave those insights. Thank you again for those people who still want to ask questions. We just have to end this also. But if you do have some follow-up questions, reach out to Glory and to Chital. Book their time already so you can understand how you can work together. I hope this session has been useful. It's been my honor to be here with you today live in Facebook and LinkedIn. Thank you for those who joined me live. For those who are watching this on replay, we're still very grateful. And please give us your email address. We'd love to share. Thank you, Shalani, also for joining us. I mean, I learned a lot from Glory and Chital, and I hope a lot of people will learn. You can still watch this on replay. And Glory, Chital, thank you. Thank you again so much.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Have a great day. Bye.
Sure, bye, guys. Bye, guys. Thank you. Bye.